Michael Scott. The Dow Jones Industrial Average down 53 points. We've got 50 minutes to go before the end of the week, but we were a lot lower earlier.
Cut our losses in half, basically. You still have some weakness in those consumer discretionary names, industrials, transports, especially weak today. Technology stocks, Maria, weak as well. So up next, the summer survival guide for housing. Mortgage rates are at record lows, so is now the time for potential buyers to make a move and buy a house? Some answers to that key question in just a moment.
And then later, the government spent nearly $800 billion to stimulate the economy. So where did the money go? Is the disappointing June jobs report evidence that the stimulus plan is just not working?
Today's Summer Survival Guide series, we zero in on housing. Mortgage rates have plunged to levels we haven't seen in 50 years. But you wouldn't know it if you looked at purchasing contracts. They've plummeted 30% in May and April. So why aren't buyers flocking to their mortgage lenders to take advantage of such low rates? As the economy continues to struggle, let's find out what potential buyers and sellers should know right now. And joining me from Philadelphia, Susan Wachter. She's professor of real estate and finance at the Wharton School of Business. And from our headquarters in New Jersey, John Sorrow is president of North Atlantic Mortgage Corporation. It's good to see you both this afternoon.
Pleasure. Good afternoon.
Susan, let me just begin with you, and let's talk broadly about the housing market. The data this past week, and really the past couple weeks, has been downright dismal. Are we headed into a double dip in housing?
I don't think so. These low mortgage rates are propping up what otherwise would be a very weak market, and I think it's going to end up flat, not negative, but flat.
However, they seem to be having such little impact. Record low mortgage rates that you cite.
Well, they are having an impact. You don't see it because there are these other forces which are on the other side, and that's particularly consumer confidence, jobs not growing, and that we have a shadow supply of underwater mortgages.
John, you're actually giving out mortgages. What are your thoughts here? Are we heading into a double dip in housing?
Well, I don't know that we are, but I agree with Susan regarding the jobs. It's all about jobs. There is a lack of confidence. A healthy jobs market will give us a healthy housing market. That's one of the most important things. Rates are historically low, but people are concerned that if they buy a home right now, that the market may still be dropping. They don't want to catch a falling knife.
Susan, can housing survive without government stimulus? It's pretty clear by now that the only reason that the housing market appeared to be doing better was because of the stimulus that the government was injecting. Can housing have any kind of robust recovery without government stimulus?
Robust recovery is absolutely in question and probably not. On the other hand, a double dip in housing, we don't necessarily see that either. More likely flat, not robust, but not contributing to a further decline in the overall recovery.
John, do you agree with that? Can the market do anything? I mean, you're right there on the front lines. Can this market survive without the government's helping hand?
Well, you know, the government's helping hand hasn't really helped very much as of late. You know, the stimulus that they offered was really minuscule, to say the least. You know, first of all, one of the first things that absolutely needs to be done is this overregulation with discriminatory legislation within our mortgage industry has to stop. This is a problem. It hinders competition. It hinders healthy competition, and it costs the consumer more money in the long run.
But John, you and I both know that that's likely here to stay.
Well, maybe, maybe not. We would like to try and fight that and try and change that. And the other thing, too, is when we talk about stimulus, one of the things the government could have done early on, and they could still do it, is they could offer the home buyers a tax write-off whereby if their home value declines in the next 5 years, they're allowed to write that off. That would restore confidence within the markets, and the markets would stabilize almost immediately, and it would cost practically nothing compared to what the original stimulus cost.
John, how have you changed the way that you're giving out mortgages? Are you seeing, I don't know, let's say a more quality buyer come to you right now? And how more discriminate are you being, I suppose, in the way that you give out mortgages?
Well, we are seeing a more quality buyer. I think people have been more educated over the last year due to the media, knowing that, no-income check loans are almost practically gone. You do have to have verifiable income, verifiable assets, a good down payment, say 10 to 20%, and good credit. We are seeing more of those buyers out there. And then the other caveat also is the appraised value of the home. Some homes are underwater, some homes are even. If you don't have equity within the home, it's very difficult to refinance. But we are seeing, I think, a better quality client come forward.
Susan, what about the foreclosure issue? That sort of remains the real issue in the room here, that regardless of what kind of activity that you get, any sort of pickup because of these low mortgage rates, that we're still going to be facing these higher levels of foreclosure rates.
that's the elephant in the room, and that shadow supply is going to keep prices depressed, not rising, and I don't see falling unless we have an increase in unemployment for quite some time to come. But let's not forget over the question of what else the federal government can do. The federal government is behind the mortgages system right now, and that's necessary for even this flat outlook.
Susan, I mean, do you have any sort of clear view on when you look at the way that housing prices are going right now, and clearly, obviously, they've come down by a significant amount. Do you have any idea or best guess, perhaps, of how long you think it's going to take before housing prices get back to, and I'm not saying pre-bust levels, but to some sort of decent level?
Well, right now, housing prices are at fundamentally rational levels. That if you look relative to rents, housing prices are not depressed. They're at correct fundamental levels. So what it will take is an overall recovery in the economy, which will boost both rents and housing prices. And that will come. It will come with job growth.
Guys, thanks so much. Enjoy the holiday weekend.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's nice spending time with you. Let's go to Phil LeBeau, who has some breaking news on Toyota. Phil.